Dear students, in this video I will explain one important derivation. Before that you remember this result, that is two lines a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0, where b1 comma b2 not equal to 0 are parallel if a1 by b1 is equal to a2 by b2, that is slope of the first line, that is minus a1 by b1 is equal to slope of the second line minus a2 by b2, that means a1 by b1 is equal to a2 by b2. Similarly, the lines are perpendicular if a1 a2 plus b1 b2 is equal to 0, and you remember these two results. And now let us derive one important result, that is distance of a point from a line. And here we have to find the distance of a point from a line, that is the length of the perpendicular drawn from the point to the line. That is, if you take a line and a point, it is possible to draw perpendicular from this point to a line, and this distance is called distance from a point to the line. Now let us derive the perpendicular distance d of a line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 from a point x1 comma y1. The question will be asked like this: derive the perpendicular distance of a line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 from a point x1 comma y1. To derive this, first let us consider the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, and we have to find the distance from the point P in bracket x1 comma y1, and let it be d. Draw a perpendicular prism from the point P to the line L, that is, this is the figure you have to draw, that is, P is a point and AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 is a line. We have to draw perpendicular from P to the line and let it be D. Now the line will intersect the X axis at Q and Y axis at R, and you know the X intercept and Y intercept of the line AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. X intercept is minus c by a, and therefore the coordinate of q is minus c by a comma 0, and y intercept is minus c by b, therefore the coordinate of r is 0 comma minus c by b, and we have the coordinates of the point p, q and r. Let the line meet the x axis and y axis at the point q and r respectively. Then the coordinates of the points are q is equal to minus c by a comma 0 and r is equal to 0 comma minus c by b, and we got the coordinate of q and r. P is already given, the coordinate of p is x1 comma y1. Thus the area of the triangle pqr is given by half into base into height. Base is qr and height is pm, that is half pm into qr. That is, PM is equal to 2 times area of triangle PQR divided by QR. Call this equation as 1. Now, P is x1, y1, Q is minus C by A, 0 and R is 0, minus C by B. And we can find the area of triangle PQR. And area of triangle PQR is equal to half into modulus of x1 into y2 minus y3, that is 0 minus minus c by b, that is 0 plus c by b, plus x2 minus c by a plus minus c by a into y3 minus y1, that is minus c by b minus y1, plus x3, that is 0 into y1 minus y2, that is y1 minus 0. And simplifying this, we have area of triangle PQR is equal to half into CX1 by B minus C by A into minus C by B, that is equal to C square by AB plus C square by AB minus C by A into minus Y1, that is plus CY1 by A plus 0. And this is the area of the triangle PQR. and that is equal to half into, taking LCM for this, LCM is AB, numerator is ACX1 plus C square plus BCY1. Now cross multiplying 2 with the area of triangle PQR, we have 2 times area of triangle PQR is equal to C by AB, here taking C common, modulus of AX1 plus BY1 plus C, and call this equation as 2. And we got 2 results. Now let us find distance QR. Q is equal to minus C by A comma 0 and R is equal to 0 comma minus C by B. And applying distance formulae, QR is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square, 0 minus minus c by a whole square, that is 0 plus c by a whole square, plus minus c by b minus 0 whole square. That is QR is equal to c square by a square plus c square by b square. Taking LCM, LCM is a square b square. That is QR is equal to square root of c square into a square plus b square divided by a square b square. And C by AB is outside the root, you will have QR is equal to C by AB into root of A square plus B square. Call this equation 3. Now substituting 2 and 3 in equation 1, we have equation 1 is PM is equal to 2 into area of triangle PQR divided by QR. We have the area of triangle PQR and QR. Substituting here, PM is equal to 2 times area of triangle PQR is equal to C by AB into modulus of AX1 plus BY1 plus C divided by QR is C by AB into root of A square plus B square. Here C by AB gets cancelled. We have PM is equal to modulus of AX1 plus BY1 plus C divided by root of A square plus B square. And this is the perpendicular distance from a point x1, y1 to the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Thus, the perpendicular distance d of a line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 from a point x1, y1 is given by d is equal to modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by root of a square plus b square. And you have to remember this result. Now let us come to the last part, that is distance between parallel lines. If the lines are parallel, then their slopes are equal. That is generally parallel lines of the form ax plus by plus c1 equal to 0 and ax plus by plus c2 is equal to 0. Either the coefficients of x and y will be same or proportional. And if the lines are not in this form, it is possible to reduce to this form. For example, 3x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0 and 6x minus 4y plus 10 is equal to 0 are parallel lines. Here coefficient of x are not equal and coefficient of y are also not equal, but it is possible to reduce it to equal just by dividing the second equation by 2. You will have 3x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0 and 3x minus 2y plus 5 is equal to 0 just by dividing the second equation by 2. And here you can observe the coefficient of x are same and coefficient of y are also same. Now to find the distance between two parallel lines, consider the parallel lines ax plus by plus c1 equal to 0 and ax plus by plus c2 is equal to 0. And these are two parallel lines. We have to find the distance between the parallel lines. And we know that the x-intercept of the line 1 is minus c1 by a, and hence you will get the point of intersection of the line 1 with the x-axis, that is minus c1 by a comma 0. And once you got the point, and we have to find the distance between the parallel line, that is distance from this point to the second line, and you can use the perpendicular distance from a point to the line, and hence we can find the distance between the two parallel lines. Now to find the perpendicular distance from A to the line, use the perpendicular distance formulae. PM is equal to modulus of AX1 plus by 1 plus 3 divided by root of a square plus b square. Here a n is equal to modulus of a into minus c1 by a plus b into 0 a x1 plus b y1 plus c, c is here c2, divided by root of a square plus b square. And simplifying, you will have a gets cancelled and a n is equal to modulus of c2 minus c1 divided by root of a square plus b square. And thus the distance d between two parallel lines a x plus b y plus c1 equal to 0 and a x plus b y plus c2 is equal to 0 is given by d is equal to modulus of c1 minus c2 divided by root of a square plus b square. And with this much, I'll conclude this video. In the next video, I'll solve the problems from the exercise. Thank you.